Introduction to Geometry, Level 7. In this final video, we're going to go over various examples and use all the concepts learned from the previous videos. Let's go ahead and jump straight into the first example. Name in all possible ways the line containing point A, R, and D. Alright, let's first locate points A, R, and D. Notice that these points lie in the same line. Recall that we symbolically denote lines by using the letters of two points and drawing a line directly on top of the letters. For this example, the line containing these three points can be named as line AR or line AD or line RA or line RD or line DA or line DR. A total of six distinct ways. For the most part, we usually want to use the expression that is in alphabetical order, whenever possible. Alright, let's try the next example. Name the sides of angle ABC. Let's first identify angle ABC. So we need to locate points A, B, and C. Having found the points, we see that we are dealing with the highlighted angle that contains point B as its vertex. Recall that angles are formed by two rays. For this angle, the two rays are ray BA and ray BC. We need to make sure that we label the vertex first, since this is technically the endpoint of each ray. Keep in mind, when you denote rays, the order of the letters matter. We need to write the endpoint first, followed by a second point. This second point indicates the direction that the ray infinitely extends towards. Alright, let's move along to the third example. Name the horizontal ray with endpoint B. Here they are asking us to identify a horizontal ray that has B as its endpoint. It is very common for students to confuse a line that is horizontal and a line that is vertical. A horizontal line can be thought as a flat or leveled line and extends to the left and to the right. You can think of the floor that you walk on as a horizontal surface. A vertical line can be thought as being upright. It extends down and up. You can think of the walls in a room as vertical surfaces since they are upright relative to the floor. For this problem, we want to identify a horizontal ray. So if we were to use point B as one endpoint, we see that the only horizontal ray that can be formed is ray BC. And this is our answer. Alright, let's move along to the next example. Which angle in the figure is angle B? Alright, we are asked to identify which angle can be named as angle B. Notice that point B is a vertex of three distinct angles, specifically angle 1, angle 3, and angle ABC, also known as angle CBA. Since point B corresponds to the vertex of three distinct angles, none of the angles can be solely called angle B. We will need to be more specific and use either the numbers or points to denote specific angles. Alright, now let's try some union and intersection problems. For these problems, you want to identify the line, line segment, ray, or angle specified, and determine the intersection or union. Let's first identify ray EC. Recall that we can think of this ray as being formed by a set of points which are represented as follows. In the same manner, ray FA is represented by the following set of points. Since we are looking for the union, we need to locate all the points on ray EC or ray FA or in both. We see that this new set forms line AC or line CA. Alright, let's try the next example. Instead of finding the union, we now want to find the intersection of these two rays. Let's go ahead and show the set of points for each ray once again. Now we want to find the intersection of these two rays. So we are looking for the region where the set of points intersect. This occurs at a line segment. So the intersection of ray EC and ray FA creates a set of points that are located on line segment EF, also known as line segment FE. Alright, let's proceed to the next example. Like always, let's mentally visualize the set of points that form ray BA and a set of points that form ray BE. In this problem, we want to find the union of these two rays. we will create a new set that contains the points of ray BA or ray BE or both. Notice that when we merge these two sets together, we end up forming an angle, specifically angle ABE or angle EBA, or more simply as angle 1. Okay, let's go to the next example. Alright, same deal. Let's mentally visualize the set of all points that forms each of the lines. For line AC, the set of points are represented as follows. And for line DR, the set of points are represented as follows. For this example, we want to find the intersection of these two lines. Looking at the set of points from both lines, we see that they have a single point in common, or single point of intersection. In this case, the intersection of line AC and line DR is equal to point A. Alright, let's end the video with the final example. The set of points represented by angle AFD are shown as follows. In the same manner, the set of points represented by line segment CE are shown as follows. We are asked to find the intersection of these two set of points. Observing the points of intersection, we see that they intersect at a given line segment. So the intersection of angle AFD and line segment CE forms the set of points located on line segment EF, or written another way as line segment FE. Alright, with the skill to identify and name the basic elements in geometry, we are ready to move along and dive deeper into the concepts of geometry. In our next series of videos, we will learn how to measure segments and angles, as well as classifying angles by size.